Thanks, you guys, for coming. If it's a little loud, you can back up. If not, it's okay. But we love Jesus and we love singing, so this is what you get. So this is Jen on the drums, and then Katie singing, and then Ellie singing, me singing, and then on guitar. So we're called The Well. Thanks for coming, and Dean will explain some of that when he speaks about The Well. And there's snacks over here, and drinks, and Bibles.
And words, if you want to see.
And words, yes, there's words right there too, underneath the rock. So, and the Bibles are free, just one per person. And even if you want to take one to give out, that would be great too. So we just want to worship God tonight and just bring Him glory.
Thank you.
Trust you in everything that we do. God, it's hard sometimes in this world to do that and to fight the battle. But God, let us be encouraged that you are still on the throne and you're King of Kings and Lord of Lords. God, I pray that we will have the heart for you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you so much for Dean coming up. I just pray that you work through him and God, that the message would just help us to be encouraged and equip ourselves for your service. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
appreciate you coming out tonight. This is The Well. It's a project that Lisa and I started thinking about 3 years ago, and then thanks to COVID, pushed it off a few years, and thankfully we were able to get Frankie and Katie involved, and now we're able to bring this out to everyone, and we're really excited to get this going this summer. We can just pray for a second. God, thank you for bringing us together tonight. Pray that you fill this place and your spirit flows through us, Lord. Lord, I pray that I can deliver your word and do justice. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So, the reason we like to call it The Well, one, I thought it was cool. And two, I really like the story of the woman at the well. And so I'd like to start with reading John, the Gospel of John, chapter 4, 13 through 26. So to give you a little bit of reference, Jesus is on his way through Samaria, and he stops at a well that was built centuries before by some famous people that are in this book that you should read. Really interesting stories. So, start at verse 13. Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again," speaking of the well. "But whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty again. The water that I will give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I will not be thirsty or have to come here to draw water." And Jesus said to her, "Go, call your husband and come here." The woman answered him, "I have no husband." Jesus said to her, "You are right in saying I have no husband, for you have had five husbands, and the one you now have is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman said to him, "Sir, I perceive that you are a prophet. Our fathers worshipped on this mountain, but you say that in Jerusalem is the place where people ought to worship." Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming and is now here when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father is seeking such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth." The woman said to him, "I know that Messiah is coming, he who is called Christ. When he comes, he will tell us all the things." Jesus said to her, "I who speak to you am he." Here is a Samaritan woman. Being from a different tribe and culture as the Jews, which Jesus was a Jew, Jesus is supposed to culturally despise this woman. But he tears down those barriers. Jesus breaks the barriers between us, between tribes, nations, races, political parties. Whatever separates us, Jesus breaks down those walls. Jesus breaks these walls by offering living waters of his spirit that will dwell in us forever if we only accept it. Jesus tells this woman, "Call your husband," already knowing she doesn't have a husband, and that she has had five husbands, and the man she is now living with is not her husband. Jesus already knows our hearts. He knows our wants, our desires, our shortcomings, and he still offers us himself to us. In her culture during these days, this woman would be looked down on. She would be an outcast. She was gathering water at the well during the hottest part of the day to avoid the judgmental looks and gossiping of the other women gathering water in the cool morning hours. The times when most women would gather the water for the day in the morning. She probably felt like the lowest of the low, like she wasn't worth anything to anyone. But here's Jesus, who until this moment in his ministry has kept the fact that he is Messiah very hush-hush. Jesus chooses this woman, who feels worthless, to proclaim that he is the Messiah, who has come down from heaven, and he will lay his lay his life down to pay the ultimate ransom for the one who feels absolutely worthless. God, being rich with mercy, because of the great love with which he loved us, even though we were dead to him in our sin and trespasses against him, made us alive together in Christ. For by his grace you have been saved, and raised us up with Christ, who we will be seated with in a heavenly place. So in the coming ages he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace and kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by God's grace you have been saved through faith in Jesus Christ. And this is not done through any of your good works, but as a free gift given by God. We are all broken people, unable to live up to God's laws. But God offers us forgiveness and grace. And the only thing he asks from us in return is to put our hope in his Son, Jesus Christ. When you put your hope in Christ, you start a relationship that fills the emptiness and loneliness you feel. Some of us try to fill that emptiness with alcohol, sex, drugs, food, gossip. These things can take away the pain and only make us feel good for a short time. But then the emptiness and hurt comes back twice over. But when you're in a relationship with Christ, we can bear all things, believe all things, hope all things, and endure all things. Jesus is the only man to live a sinless life. He went to the cross willingly, carrying your burdens and your sins, and my burdens and my sins, and was killed on that cross. He was buried, and 3 days later conquered death, rising from the grave, so that whoever follows him can build a relationship with our Father, the creator of the universe, and so we can spend eternity praising him in paradise. All that is required to take that first step and to draw into a relationship with Christ is to simply ask him to come into your life. If you are ready to ask Jesus to come into your life, or if you are a follower of Christ and are longing to reconnect to your Savior, I invite you to pray this with me. God, thank you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, into the world to show us your love, mercy, and grace. Thank you for his loving sacrifice on the cross, separating me from my sins. Thank you that he conquered death so that I might praise you forever and ever, Lord. Jesus, I pray that you come into my life, Lord. I long to be in your presence. It's in your holy name that I pray. Amen. Praise be to God. If you still have questions or not sure of the next steps, myself and the others in the fancy blue t-shirts would love to talk to you more about it. And when you're ready to ask Jesus into your life, the words don't matter. Just talk to him and tell him that you're thankful for his free gift and ask him to come into your life. Thank you. Thank you.
Treasures, because they're going to break down, they're going to catch on fire, they're going to be stolen. But God, if we put it in you, if we trust in you, then the spiritual can never be destroyed. Thank you for letting us be here tonight. Help us just worship you in truth and in spirit. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. When I was growing up, it was like this. Have you been to Jesus for the time? I'm like, I'm not dead yet. So we're going to speed this up a little. Have you been to Jesus? Of this earth for spiritual things, and it's awesome, because when you it's just awesome. So we're trading everything.
I'm
Why we were saying yes, yes. So be it. It's final, it's good. Alright, since we're just gonna throw one more in there. And everybody should know this one, so. We didn't practice this, I know, but I'm feeling it and we need to do it. Because some one of these days I'm gonna fly away. Some glad morning. When life is over, I'll fly away. I want this played at my funeral, so I just want to tell you.
Okay.
I have a funeral CD. Like, I literally made a CD of songs that I want at my funeral. And my funeral will be a party. It will have balloons and a cake, because I'm going to heaven. So much for letting us be here tonight, that we can be encouraged by songs and a message that just should touch our heart. God, I pray that we will be encouraged by one another's fellowship as we leave, but God, let us leave with encouragement and love. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
And 2 Thursdays from now, we'll be right here again at 7 o'clock.
Yep. And there's food over there and water. Just hang out with each other. Encourage.